All they did was pivot. All right, do it a few times so they can see it a little bit slower, like a dancing ballerina. There you go. That way they can see the actual pivot. Do it again a few more times. All right, that way you guys can practice this. Simple. All right, go this way so they can see it again. All he's doing is stepping back to the side, pivoting. All right, keep doing it. Notice his guards. As he's shifting his body weight, he's shifting his guard as well. All right. Perfect. See right here, his shoulder's ready to block. Right here's any counter on this side. His jab was in front of his face right there. Pivoting over and over, right? So that's what it looks like. A few times it's full speed. Boom, boom. All right, this side. Boom, boom. All right? So that's how the footwork goes. Now we're going to show you how to either counter, if the possibility is there, basically just eliminate that straight jab real quick. So go ahead and counter with just a straight. Boom, boom, boom. All right, so you're gonna use that step back to mount, use it as a plyometric sense to bounce back in to throw a lot of power. Boom, boom. All right, now realistic, no pausing. Do it this side, so you can see it sideways. Good, one more time. Get away. All right, so now you can do one last thing for that. Let's add the, so that's in case that, if the fighter is fast enough to go ahead and do it one last time slow, boom, boom, boom. Right, in case he's fast enough to do that, to evade that straight, right? Now right here, I'm stuck. I can't really punch over. Right? I can't really do an uppercut because the way I'm set up, but he's ready with his uppercut. Go ahead and show the uppercut, boom, and then come down with the boom. Alright, I know it looked awkward right there because he was a little bit off balance because he had to do it slow, but I will go a little bit smooth, a little bit playful. Bam, bam, boom, boom, boom. Alright, so that first straight now is not a haymaking straight. It's just a misdirecting straight. He's just basically going to throw his shoulder. That's it. Open his hand up a little bit so it really does look like a punch. But that way you're not opening up. Scoot over a little bit. That way you're not opening up that guard. Alright, so that's all he's going to do. Bam. Just like that. So see, I really didn't punch. All right, why? Because now I'm set up to uppercut and then come down again. All right, so Roman Marquez does it a lot. Mayweather does it every once in a while. Forgot his name. Roman Lopez. I'll tell you later. Anyhow, so here we go. I can't believe I forgot his name. Anyhow, so here we go. We're gonna show you the actual full combination now. Nice and slow and playful. Bam, bam. All right, now he's gonna go a little bit quicker now. The first two shots, the straight and the uppercut is nice and light, setting up for that overhand right or overhand hookish right, whichever way you need to execute it once it's there. All right, so bam, sorry, one more time, boom, boom. All right, and listen to the taps, how much quicker they're gonna get. They're not gonna get heavier, but you're gonna hear them louder. Boom, boom. There you go, so boom, boom, boom. All right, ha, ha. There you go. One last time, get away. Good. Just like that, sideways real quick. Alright. I messed up. Another time. Boom, boom. One more time. In case I counter, see how you moved. Alright, so that's against an orthodox. Now we're going to show you the real thing against a southpaw. Alright, so we'll show you this way first. So you can see how I will go. All right, so basically, Lara, I'll show you the difference between Lara and Pacquiao's 1-2, all right? So Pacquiao's 1-2, he does it more like this, straight down the pipe. Why? Because he's a natural righty, okay? So that's why he can get away with doing that and he still feels good with his balance, with his core and all that. Lara is a natural lefty, so he naturally has to cross over. It doesn't mean he's going to cross way over like that. That just means he has more power, he's more deadly, more effective towards that side because he naturally crosses over because he's a natural lefty. All right, on this side, he has connected over here, but not too many times. He's not that accurate, stuff like that. Anyhow, so remember, he's going to go towards the right if you're seeing the orthodox, the southpaw. Anyhow, so what you would do is from here is you would do the complete opposite almost. In the sense that now he's just gonna push off with his lead foot, step off with his rear foot. Against the orthodox, you will step over with your lead foot first and then push off. Now, the southpaw, you must step over with the rear foot and push up with the front foot. Go ahead and do it, just like that. All right, so let's go ahead and try it now. So basically, once he moves, that eliminates the jab. All right, obviously the straight's not gonna be there. I'm gonna do it quick now. All right, so I barely touched his shoulder right now. All right, but I was nowhere near his head. And like I said, I barely touched his shoulder. This is what this is, so they can see the distance, how much is being created. All right, and I actually fought. I know you can't see from this angle, but I followed him over there, and I still was nowhere near him. All right, that's what I mean about Lara too. Lara won't be able to go that way, follow Canelo that way. All right, so he'll be wide open right here for a devastating overhand right. Easy overhand right. All right, so here we go, nice and slow again. Bam, bam, boom, right there you can get hit. All right, now let's go ahead and hit it. Good, and then get out of the way. Good, one more time. Good. All right, this way so they can be copying you. All right, so let's go slow. So all he's gonna do is step out with his rear foot. Go ahead, bam, bam. All right, see how much you move? Once again, let's go this way. Bam, bam. All right, so let's go ahead realistic now. Bam, bam. Good, get away. Boom, boom. Good, one more time. Boom, boom. All right, let's go this way. Good. Right there. Good. Alright, so now we're gonna show you what to do to counter a little bit. Alright, so sit on that side. So same thing, he's gonna step out. Bam, bam. Alright, he's gonna come in, but he's just gonna do a feintish straight. Go ahead and do the feintish straight. If I were to evade that, go ahead. Bam, bam. Go ahead, do that trick. Boom. If I were to evade that, go this way. All right, because you know how lefties like to side crunch this way. All right, Pacquiao does it a lot, stuff like that. Anyhow, right here, again, I'm not set up good. He is. All right, right there, you can do an uppercut, the uppercut, and then up, down again. All right, but it's all how you feel. Let's go ahead and do it proper now. All right, just like that. Let's do the up, down. There you go. All right, let's try to do the mitts now. Bam, bam. Just like that. All right, a few more times. Alright, go this way. Good. Again. Good. Just like that. Alright, so once again, this was a demonstration on how an orthodox fighter can eliminate the jab straight, the 1-2 combination from an orthodox or a southpaw. But again, this is in reference and relevance to the Lara versus Canelo fight. And this is obviously orthodox, so this is how Canelo can eliminate the 1-2 of Lara. All right, so once again, my name is